I'm Dr. Peter Bloomfield, and I'm based out of an academic center in Los Angeles, California. And what was most exciting to me about being here at Inner Awakening is the concept of the genetic change that is happening, no doubt, in the participants here through the work of Swamiji. Historically, we were taught that DNA is something that you get and you're born with, and there's nothing you can do about it, and it can only evolve over millions and billions of years. Which was a very limiting belief. But there's a whole new field of science coming up that's very new and exciting now called epigenetics that shows that actually we can change our DNA in real time. And so things like having a bad diet or lots of stress, emotionally traumatic experiences, they create molecular changes in your DNA. These changes can then be passed on to your offspring. Meanwhile, things like having a good diet, meditation, and other healthy interventions and states of mind, again, affect molecular changes in your DNA that can be passed on to your children. So the healthy changes are going to make proteins be expressed differently so that your body will be made over differently in a more healthy way. And the unhealthy patterns and the unhealthy changes in DNA will do the opposite. So with the understanding of that and looking at the work we're doing with Swamiji here, between the Kundalini awakening, lots of meditation, special diets, a huge amount of emotional healing, there's no doubt in my mind that all kinds of genetic transformation is taking place. And if anyone has any doubt, you can just remember that little girl with the blindfold. I can't think of a more compelling piece of evidence than that. But what is, and what is even as exciting for me is that this organization is actually doing research, not just talking about it. And so just one example of what they've done already is they've looked at proteins in the blood of people before and after this program. And they found that after the 21-day program, proteins that are healthy and create a healthy immune system had gone way up, whereas proteins that were unhealthy had gone significantly down. And what this suggests is that the DNA is changing, making more healthy proteins be transcribed or manufactured, and less unhealthy ones. And the research is early, and we'll know more as time goes on, but we'd expect this would be carrying on generation after generation. So people who are going here could make changes in their family genetics that will continue. Now, I think the next step would be to take a look at the actual genetic material of people before and after this program and look for the molecular changes. And what's really exciting to me as a spiritually minded physician is that we could be getting into the study of the genetics of enlightenment. And just the profundity of what that could mean for the human condition, I think, is hard to describe. So, thank you.
I'm general practitioner from United Kingdom, working in National Health Service for many years. It is Swamiji's Inner Awakening program. I found it totally transformational personally to feel it. And I see general population, which is mainly for general medical purposes, and 40 to 50% of my patients normally suffer from anxiety, stress-related disorders, and depression and addiction problems. I used to think that they are lacking spiritual background for them, and all these problems stem from there. And they normally, we refer them to the counseling sessions, and also we prescribe tranquilizers and antidepressants. But all this medication has got its own problems with various side effects. They suffer, and they are very toxic to the body, and also they will have interactions with other drugs. And also it is very difficult to wean them off once they are on it for some time, and they always struggle to come off these drugs. And indefinitely they will be taking these drugs with all ill effects on their physical body. So the spirituality to really introduce the Inner Awakening program is the best place for them to really, because Swabiji has evolved and various components into this program, introducing the burning of the root patterns and completion process, and with all these various components, spirituality included, they will have a good package to deal with the general population. And also, another I forgot to mention about psychosomatic illnesses. Another 10% to 15% patients suffer. So majority of the patients will definitely benefit by attending Inner Awakening program. And I strongly recommend them to come to Swamiji to participate in this Inner Awakening program. Thank you.
I am a qualified physician from India for last 27 years. We were part of the first successful heart transplantation in 1995 from Chennai. Then I moved on. I was a visiting professor in Washington University, St. Louis, Missouri. Right now, I'm actually working in Canada as a part of a clinical faculty in Memorial University. What all I am going to say now, I would say even if I'm not in this costume, because this is a true feeling about Inner Awakening and Swamiji. I'm going to speak a little bit about Nirahara Samyama. You know, Inner Awakening is literally a million-mile journey in 21 days. But regarding the medical facts itself, it's like an eye-opener for me with all that experience I hold on to. Nirahara Samyama is a, on its own, it's a Nobel Peace Prize winner for Swamiji. If some of the, you know, Western medicine, we could drop some of our incompletions and try to, you know, hold on to the concepts of Nirahara Samyama. Nirahara Samyama is makes your inner awakening as a complete and a super process, mainly because Nirahara Samyama includes completion, you know, where you break all your food patterns, and the food patterns have a lot of incompletions as a part of the life. And it is the only method which so far I have seen clinically, which is probably the best and probably a fail-proof system. A lot of other methods could work, but probably later on they could revert back. And the part of the Nirahara Samyama, you know, when you practice it as a whole package, it also makes you a more peaceful and a better person so that you could work better with your social circumstances. You practice Advaita along that, you know, when you break off all your incompletions in food patterns. All that we eat every day is actually, we are encouraging an inner dog sitting in us, which just thrives on all the incompletions we have got. So it's so quick to understand when Swamiji gives initiation and then to practice. You know, that's all I can say. You know, everybody should experience it to understand how does it work. And then, you know, there's a lot of medical problems associated with obesity and the related problems. Billions of dollars are spent on all these patients. It's really an eye-opener for me in this program. There are many other things, but this actually stood out very well for me. Thank you. Thank you, Swami.
My name is Dr. Shilpa Anil Kumar. I am from Tumkur, India. I am a homeopathic practitioner practicing for the past 17 years. As a doctor, the reason I would recommend Inner Awakening is for the benefits that it gives in curing the chronic health problems, diseases. And as a homeopath, as a doctor, we recommend is a holistic approach for any disease to be cured. For any disease to happen, the reason would be the disturbance either in the mind or the body or the emotions and the vital force or the prana. And what I saw here was Swamiji works on all the four through panchakriya through nirahara samyama and through kriyas and more than everything the energy darshan that he gives that directly works on a vital force. So what I saw was with this kind of approach for on all the areas which causes diseases, definitely any kind of mental or physical ailment, chronic ailment, can definitely get cured and can enjoy great health. For me personally, I had chronic plantar psoriasis, which is an autoimmune disease, which is on my feet, and it was very bad, quite severe. This is my second IA. During my first IA, with all the processes, as I said, and especially I forgot to mention the completion process that we do, which directly works on the emotions and the mind. It really helped me, and after all this, now it's almost gone. And I'm sure after completing this IA, it will completely disappear. So what I would recommend is anybody who has any sort of chronic mental or physical disease can get completely cured with inner awakening by Swamiji's grace. Thank you so much.